Blackstone presents One Little Word by Audra McElyea. This book is read by Eileen Stevens. For the man who can find me anywhere. Chapter 1. If hot meals are deadly to mothers, then my 3-year-old son Graham saves me from impending death every night at 6 o'clock. Tonight, I plop down on the couch with Graham and prepare to eat leftover chicken, broccoli, and mashed potatoes, all cold due to the eternal fetching I've been doing for my child since we got home. It never fails. He sees my joyful face anticipating my first warm dinner in weeks, and he instantly needs at least 3 objects at once. Objects I must retrieve immediately, or else. I know I'm not the only mom who lives in fear of her toddler. My best friend, Violet, also dreads her 3-year-old son's colossal tantrums, the big ones where a parent thinks they might need to call an exorcist or construct a padded room so the kid can survive a minor disappointment. Unlike me, though, Vi has the support of her husband, Nick, who salvages her remaining sanity by helping out when he's home from work. It must be nice to have a partner down in your foxhole every day, dodging stray bullets by your side. Being a 25-year-old widow with a 3-year-old wasn't something I planned, but it's the hand I was dealt. And the last thing I want to do is pick a fight with my son. I'm already drowning in a sea of mom guilt over not being able to stay home with him during the day like his friends' moms do, and tonight's looming thunderstorm is likely to freak him out. So I want to keep the peace. After fetching Graham a different blanket for the 3rd time, I flip on the TV, and WKNX's live news coverage comes on, as if 8 straight hours of seeing Tess Miller's face at work wasn't torment enough. She's a decent anchor, but her talent comes with an ego the size of Texas. To her, I'm just a lowly journalist and substitute reporter. Whenever we cross paths, she accidentally calls me Madison or Addie, although she knows my name is Madeline. It's her condescending power play designed to tear down the confidence of a fellow colleague. Mommy, can I watch Paw Patrol, please? Graham's eyes gleam with childlike purity. Or maybe manipulation. Either way, it works. I click the previous channel button. Sure, baby. I catch a teaser for an upcoming news story about a local death, but I've already committed to Graham's favorite show and press the button. There's no turning back. Make sure you eat all your chicken and broccoli so you can have that cookie memes left you. With an excited grin, he shoves the meat into his mouth faster than my sprint out the door of WKNX 2 hours ago. Tess repeatedly called me Madison at our brainstorming meeting today, and the kicker was that Perry, our boss, didn't bother to correct her. He chimed in and called me Madison too so as not to call out Tess for her mistake in front of everyone. I sat there and took it, though, and fumed at the workplace politics. I shove a few bites of dinner into my mouth and roll my eyes as I picture myself sitting silently at the meeting while everyone proceeded to call me Madison. But I pause when I note Graham's full-mouthed, dimple-inducing grin. It's just like his dad's. I drop my fork and squeeze him. Nothing could make me love this kid more. And even though I had a bad day at work, I realize how lucky I am to be his mom. The ringing of my phone echoes through our apartment as the power flickers. Graham sprints to the kitchen and grabs it for me, oblivious to the shaking lights. Mad's phone, he answers with a giggle before tossing it to me. I jump from the couch to catch it, relieved I have decent hand-eye coordination so I don't have to drop another couple hundred I don't have on a new phone. Thanks, bub. I wince as I answer, hoping it isn't Perry. He's not exactly kid-friendly and would think it unprofessional that Graham picked up my phone. I stiffen. This is Madeline. Hey, honey, did you see Tess Miller on the news just now? The familiar voice of my mom sends me sliding back down to the couch as I continue to eat and talk. I'd rather gag myself with my spoon than watch Tess, even though the lead-in to that story did sound intriguing. No, we're watching Marshall get himself into another pickle on Paw Patrol. Why? What's going on? I glance to my right, and Graham has shoved his entire...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.